start with a solid state. Okay, solid state. So there are, normally there are three different states of matter we have. Okay? That one, no? Reversible reaction. Show me the notes, last one. This one formula I will give you. Yes, yes, yes. So there's a reversible reaction one formula, I'll give you that formula. Okay. This is one formula for reversible reaction. What is the concentration of AB in a reversible reaction at any time? Okay. So that is one formula I'll give you that. Because this derivation is so big, so we are not doing that. Not that important also. Okay, so I'll give you that formula. Solid state will start. There are three different states of matter we have that we already know. That is solid, liquid and gas. Okay, what is the basic difference among these three states of matter? The basic difference is what? Intermolecular force of attraction, okay, IMF. IMF in solid is maximum, right? So here it is strong intermolecular force, you see, strong intermolecular force. The liquid is weak, and the gaseous state has very weak intermolecular force of attraction. Okay, so because of weak intermolecular force, liquid particles can move, right? That's why the water and any other liquid state can flow. Okay, because the molecules, the bonding between the molecules is not that strong, so molecules can move. Okay, that is the reason why the liquid and fluids, all these particles flows. Okay. Gaseous particles, we know there is random motion in gaseous particles. All the gaseous particles move in random direction. Okay, and when it strikes to the wall, it exerts pressure. Okay, so random motion of gaseous particles we have, again, because of weak interaction among the molecules. If these two are interacting, so its motion will be hindered because of this interaction force. Okay, in solid particle, what happens, the molecules of solid particles are attached by a very strong bond or intermolecular force, we can say. That's why if you want to break any solid particles, you have to break this bond. And since it is strong, so you have to apply some force on it. Okay? So basic difference is intermolecular force. You keep on increasing intermolecular force, you convert the states of matter into each other. Right? Very weak to weak, weak to strong, it becomes solid. So liquid particles, gaseous particles will have a certain range of intermolecular force. If you exceed that range, the gas starts converting into liquid. Further, you increase the intermolecular force, liquid starts converting into solid. The best example we have of water converting into ice. H2L liquid, so it converts into ice, solid. When this happens, when you put this water into any low temperature zone, like in freezer, if you put the water in freezer, then it converts into ice after some time. Okay. So what happens at low temperature? The liquid particles has very less kinetic energy. Okay, as temperature decreases, kinetic energy also decreases. However, it is true for gaseous particles, 3/2 kT kinetic energy of gaseous molecules, you know. But it is true for solid and liquid also. Okay, as you increase, the relation may be different, but as temperature decreases, kinetic energy of liquid particles also decreases. Okay, so when kinetic energy decreases, the liquid particles moves with a lesser speed. Okay, and when the speed is less, they can interact. Okay, and when interaction possible, it means intermolecular force is increasing. So after some time, what happens, if this intermolecular force keeps on increasing, this starts converting into solid. Okay, so liquefaction of gas also we have discussed in gaseous state, conversion of gas into liquid, that is liquefaction of gas. Then we have two different factors. One is pressure, when we decrease the pressure and when we decrease the temperature, increase the pressure or decrease the temperature. When pressure increases, what happens? The average distance between the molecule also decreases, because when pressure increases, volume decreases. Volume decreases means gaseous particles are coming closer. So if you want to increase the intermolecular force, you have to decrease the distance or average distance between the particles or molecules, or you have to decrease the temperature so that kinetic energy decreases, speed decreases and interaction. Okay, That's why these are the factors we have, these two factors we discuss in liquefaction of gas, okay. The objective is what? Objective is to increase the intermolecular force so that the change of state is possible, okay. So in this chapter we are going to deal with solid state, okay. So maximum intermolecular force of interaction we have, okay. We will also see the packing of solids, okay. Solid particles generally what we assume, they have spherical shape, okay, spherical shape. So in the arrangement of solid particle, you see it is not perfectly arranged, means there will be some vacant space, that we call it as void. Suppose you have particles like this, and when you arrange like this side by side, okay, like this if you arrange, so obviously you have some void present, right, these are the voids, okay. Why these voids are there? Because the shape is spherical. If it is a square or something like this, then the void won't be there, right? You can place a square like this perfectly, you know, efficiency is completely one, okay, or 100% you can say, okay. So because of the shape of the molecules, the efficiency is not 100% and we'll have some void present into this, okay. Now this void can be of different types, octahedral void ho sakta hai, tetrahedral void ho sakta hai, triangular void ho sakta hai, 2D, 3D void, all these things are possible, right. So we'll discuss about voids, how this void forms, okay. And we'll also see ionic crystals. Ionic crystals, see, there are two types of crystal, covalent and ionic, metallic also we have, non-structural material also we have. Well, important one is ionic one and covalent, okay. In covalent what happens, the atoms will have the same size, carbon-carbon atoms are in, like in diamond, correct. So all are carbon atoms, so size of carbon atom will be what? Same, right. In ionic crystal what happens, you have ions, like NaCl, Na plus and Cl minus. So this size will be more than this. So ionic crystal mein kya hoga? Size will be different of ions. Okay. So generally what happens, cations are present in voids and ions occupy the lattice points. Okay, lattice points. There are some exceptions also in which anion occupy voids. We'll see that. Okay. So structures of various compounds like NaCl, ions, oxides of ions, okay, ZnS, Bozide structure, zinc blend structure, all these things we'll see. But before that we have to understand what is the different types of lattice, okay, what is lattice point, what is coordination number, what is rank of any unit cell, what is unit cell, all these things we have to discuss. Coordination number wo wala nahi hai, coordination compound wala, it is different, okay. So we'll see all these things and then we'll discuss. So basically in this chapter, this is one part of the chapter. The second part is about, it's all about theory, like semiconductor you must have done in physics, okay. So here we have, we'll have extrinsic, intrinsic semiconductor, theoretical based question, theory based question they ask into that. Another thing is ferromagnetic substance, paramagnetic, diamagnetic, ferrimagnetic, all these things are there. So the last part of this chapter is theoretical, okay. So I'll give you notes onto that, okay. It's not very much, you know, I'll dictate only because it's completely theory. What are the important things, I'll let you know, okay. So here we'll start with next write down. There are two types of solid. You have done this chapter in the school?
No.
It's not there. 11th में भी नहीं है क्या?
We did it.
11.
We did it.
This is not. अच्छा, it's not there in the school. Okay, so, but in JEE we'll have it. Okay, so we have to do it. Not any other exam. Okay, write down. There are two types of solid generally. One is amorphous. It's like this right now. Amorphous and crystalline. We'll see the difference of these two. Amorphous and crystalline solid. Okay. Amorphous solid, write down in this point wise write down. Point number one. It is irregular arrangement. Irregular arrangement. Means irregular arrangement means there is no pattern in this. Okay? Atoms are arranged in, there is no ordered manner. Okay, randomly it is arranged. Okay. But crystalline solid, we have ordered arrangement. Okay, regular arrangement or ordered arrangement. Okay, like all these examples you write down. Amorphous will have plastic, rubber, you can also say coal. There's no regular pattern into that. But if you see crystalline, diamond, okay, graphite, or any other, any CL structure, then there is a pattern, there is an ordered arrangement, means position of atoms will be fixed, there is a geometry fixed into this, okay. Second point you write down in this, it has definite and sharp melting point. in this one you are writing, no? It has no sharp melting point. MFS may no sharp melting point. Here we have definite and sharp melting point. Crystalline structure, definite and sharp melting point. Here, MFS, no sharp melting point. No sharp melting point. You must have seen plastic melts over a range of temperature. Okay, that is no sharp melting point. But in the case of solid, the melting point of water is what? Melting point, 0 degrees. So sharp melting point we have for this, okay? Amorphous, we also call it pseudo-solid. Generally, solids has sharp melting point. Since it does not have the sharp melting point, that's why we call it as pseudo-solid. Crystalline is true solid. Crystalline is true solid. Amorphous, we write down, its properties are not direction dependent. Amorphous solid properties are not directional dependent. This we call it as isotropy. Isotropy means what? Property is independent of direction. Okay, isotropy. Isotropy. Crystalline, write down anisotropy. This is important. Anisotropy. Its properties are. Properties depends upon direction. Okay, diamond के बारे में you must have heard कि एक direction से cut करना easy होता है. If you cut diamond at a particular angle, it is easier than the other. Okay, so that's what its tensile strength depends upon the direction, right? That's why if you want to cut the diamond, it is not easy to cut from every direction. Okay, because when you have atoms interact directly in a one particular direction, it's difficult to cut from that direction. Okay, so when the properties are directional dependent, it is anisotropy, and amorphous are isotropy. Okay, these are 3-4 difference. Sometimes they ask this. This term you must remember: isotropy and anisotropy. Directional dependent, it is independent of direction. Okay. Next, write down. There are certain terms we use in this chapter. Okay. In this, the first thing you write down the terms related to a crystal. Terms related to a crystal. The first term you write down. The first term is lattice point. Lattice point. These are the positions or points. These are the positions or points where the atoms. Position or points where the atoms are placed. Atoms, ions, molecules, anything you can say. Atoms, ions in the case of what? Ionic solids. When you have ionic crystals, right? Atoms, ions, molecules are placed. Okay, all those points are lattice points. Okay, next term you write down. Just one more line you write in this write down. Lattice points are joined together. Lattice points are joined together to get the geometry of the lattice. To get the geometry of the lattice. Geometry of the lattice. Joined together to get the geometry of the lattice. Okay? And generally we join this by a straight line. Okay, that you must keep in mind. Straight lines. Second point you write down. Crystal lattice. Crystal lattice. It is the 3D arrangement of lattice points. 3D arrangement of lattice points. 3D arrangement of lattice points. Third one. Unit cell. Unit cell. Okay, write down. It is the smallest part of the crystal lattice. It is the smallest part of the crystal lattice which when repeated in all direction, which when repeated in all direction, j generates the entire lattice. Generates the entire lattice. Okay.